The summit itself may be over, but the clashes between police and protesters continue at this hour.
There is another standoff in Oakland where several hundred people have gathered. Let's get right to David Highfield, who is live in Oakland. David, what's going on?
Patrice, very intense situation here right now. We are standing in the middle of Forbes Avenue. It has been shut down to traffic, and take a look down there. You're going to see hundreds of police in riot gear. There are two SWAT vehicles there with loudspeakers that have been telling the crowd that this is an unlawful assemblage and they need to disperse or they could be arrested. And they have been standing right down there at the right. This is right near the Cathedral of Learning. All right, right now, more riot police are coming from behind, and they are moving down past our point here with our live truck. They're heading that direction down. We're in the block of the Cathedral of Learning trying to assist the other police officers that are down there right now. They're moving kind of slowly at this point. They have their shields up. And earlier it appeared as though one protester may have been knocked to the ground down there earlier, but it was kind of difficult to see from this vantage point, but again, more riot police are headed down that way. I want to go to some videotape right now because just about 10 minutes ago, police officers sprayed what appeared to be either OC spray or canisters of smoke. This was right in front of the student union building, the Pitt Student Union building, trying to get protesters dispersed. This all began as a police resistance rally here just about an hour ago in Schenley Plaza. The rally seemed rather unorganized, and there were hundreds of police officers. In fact, there were probably more police officers than there were people at the actual rally. But these officers moved in riot gear, surrounded the group of demonstrators. Then just about 20 minutes ago, it was clear they weren't going to take it anymore. They began circling around the plaza, trying to get the crowds to disperse, letting them know that this was illegal, that they were gathering there, and that they needed to leave immediately. For the most part, a lot of that crowd did disperse, and then they fired near the Pitt Student Union some gas canisters again, or smoke canisters, because much of the crowd moved over that direction. And now we're looking at live again here in the block of the Cathedral of Learning as police in riot gear are surrounding these remaining protesters that are apparently refusing to go. Now, earlier I talked with some of them about why they were here, what brought them here this evening to this police resistance rally. Let's listen to that.
You know, we're all very angry. I saw some of the events that unfolded last night. We want them to know we're not going to take this. We can't have them hurting our peers, hurting innocent bystanders because they're overreacting to a situation.
I don't think it's really necessary to have, like, hundreds of cops here. Like, it's really not that necessary to have that.
All right, we are back live right now. You're taking a look at a police helicopter that is shining a spotlight down right here onto Forbes Avenue. We're right by the Cathedral of Learning. And in fact, while we were listening to those interviews, many of those riot officers in, or many of the police officers in riot gear, they all charged. They charged inward towards Hines Chapel there. And it's difficult to see from this vantage point why they went that way. Some of them have police dogs with them, and they're very serious about getting this crowd dispersed and not having any trouble here this evening. I have to tell you, a lot of the people that were gathered in Schenley Plaza have left the area. It really seemed as though there's really a small contingent left, but clearly they are not following the orders of police, and that's why police are out here again. So far, we have not seen any incidents of violence, but we will stay here and we will join you again live with any new information as soon as something happens here that is warranted for us to break in again. That's the very latest right now from Oakland. David Highfield, KDKA TV News.